Hey, welcome back. We're here with John Edward, who agreed to sit down with me and try to communicate with some of the loved ones who I've lost over the years. It was really interesting, though. John often says that during his readings, signals get crossed, messages from anyone who's kind of in the area or in the room can come through. That is certainly what happened in the reading that we did. The cameras were unexpectedly turned on a couple of my cameramen. John had not met either of them before the shoot. Take a look.
If I say Richard or Robert, where's that for you?
My uncle named Robert Fulton died in a plane crash.
Is that the family with the twins?
I'm a twin.
You're done. Okay, done. I just needed to know where I'm going with this. Somebody's pregnant in your family?
You just had a baby. I just became an uncle 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, they told me to talk about the baby, congratulate about the baby. So this is their way of saying, like, we see what's going on in the family. And your mom's still here?
Yeah.
I need to acknowledge your mom.
My mom's sick, but she was diagnosed with brain cancer.
She has a contemporary who's passed. Her brother is coming through.
Brother died when he was 2 years old.
There's an L-sounding name that's connected to them in some way.
His name was Lynn.
Lynn, okay. But you need to let your mom know that her brother is there and is around her. You just need to let your mom know that she's not alone. She's feeling a little isolated, a little, you know that? So I don't know if she's in a different place from you, or she's in a different state from you, or she's feeling removed from you and you can't get to her in some way. But you kind of need to communicate with your mom. You need to talk to her about what's happening in your life. I feel like it's important for her to have a dialogue with you, but it's more important for you to have a dialogue with her. Were you, at one point, contemplating suicide?
Never.
Do you know if there was somebody who you talked to about that? They were contemplating it, where you had a conversation
about
it?
Yeah, my older sister tried to commit suicide.
Okay, did you have a conversation with her about this?
Post. I mean,
you've talked about it?
Yeah.
Okay. I feel like what was going on with your sister, I don't know if she was dealing with a chemical imbalance, if she was bipolar and self-medicating, but
pretty much cocktail of all three.
Yeah, I literally feel like she was trying to find her place and having an issue with the older male, dad, having an issue with the father figure, and feeling misunderstood. So I don't know if your conversation helped move her through this, but I really do feel like it did in a big, big way. There's a vehicle accident here. Somebody died in a car accident. Is that for you?
Yeah. My niece died a single passenger accident, 19 years old, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. Texting and driving.
Because he's telling me that the person who passed in the vehicle accident is here. That's your niece?
It's my wife's niece.
Did somebody that she knew came on the scene of the accident?
It was right by their house.
Is Kristen or Christine connected to her?
Yeah, Christina.
Is that her sister?
This is crazy. Sorry, this is a tough shoot. Christina is my wife's other niece.
You know she's Christina Marie?
I believe she is.
She's in good hands, family-wise. Okay?
Thanks.
You're very welcome. I hope it helps them.
Thanks.
Please welcome the cameraman Elgin, and also cameraman George Olga. Stand up also. I saw you crying there, George, stand up. I saw you crying there. What do you think hearing that?
My cousin, it wasn't my niece, my cousin passed away 2 months ago today.
2 months ago today?
In a car accident. It was a single car accident.
I'm so sorry about that.
Thank you. She was 20 years old.
Is there anything you want to say to John?
Thank you. Thank you for taking this brave step to help people, because I know you're attacked all the time. And whenever you take a stand like that, you're going to be attacked, but you keep going on. You don't let people stop you, and you keep going, and you are helping people. Thank you.
John, you look, clearly this is emotional for you.
Yes. Just thank you.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. And George, you came to the shoot. I mean, you didn't even know really what shoot you were coming to, right?
No.
Do you believe in this? Do you not?
Before the shoot, I had no belief in it at all. I just didn't give any weight to it. Then once these things started happening, it was so bizarre because I'm just there as a camera guy. I'm not even really listening. And then when you're saying these things, it's kind of made me a believer in it, yeah.
You've actually changed your mind on it?
I changed my mind over it, yeah.
Yeah, interesting. Yeah. I appreciate both of you being here.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. And again, I'm so sorry for your family's loss, and I hope this helps in some way.
Me too.
Yeah.
I really do.
Elgin is also here with your whole family. Your mom's here, your dad's here, your sister's here. What do you make of what happened?
It was surreal. We just came there to do work. But then when he actually said something about my family that I don't think anybody else would know if you weren't close to us.
He said that you were a twin.
Yeah.
Which I didn't know.
He said, I see the number 4 and as an April, and he goes, and you're a twin, right?
And your family's here as well. Heather and Cynthia and Ron, your dad, thank you so much for being with us. What was it like hearing some of the things John said?
I'm still recovering from watching the video. I was stunned. I am amazed at the power of what people who've passed away in our lives can do for us. Our family has gone through a great deal of hardships in the last year. My brain cancer is in remission right now.
That's great.
When we recognize the connections that we have to the people that have passed and also beings in our presence, I think the support that our family has from these presents would fill Yankee Stadium.
Heather, for you, it's clearly emotional too.
Hearing this, though, confirms something for me, which I've often called Elgin my guardian angel. He's my youngest brother. After my suicide attempt failed and I was on the gurney in the psych ward, I knew that I couldn't go back to that headspace because I had to be there for Elgin and my other sister, Laurel. The hardest part about this is having to remember that it happened, because I don't often think about it. But it's also really healing to know that it's valid and it's verifiable and that you can recover from it and you can come back. And you can come back a lot stronger with the help of your family.
Yeah. Yeah. It was such a great family. You've got such a great family. It's so nice. Ron, for you, hearing all this.
Well, I admit I'm quite astonished. It shows to me that there's a spiritual profundity that's available that we just aren't sensitive to, but that is there all the time to enrich our lives.
It is remarkable to me, John. I mean, obviously, look, I'm still don't know what I think about this. As a reporter, I look at things, what I can prove, what evidence I see, but it's got to be remarkable for you to hear the impact this has on families' lives.
Absolutely. I'm overwhelmed, just to be really honest. Like, I knew I was coming out here, I was nervous for a reason. Your statement literally flattened me out. You do what you do and you try to make a difference, and I have a motto that I like to leave people better than I find them. But I'm also, your mom and I was talking, I have an Aquarian moon, and astrologically that allows me to disconnect from the emotion of things so I can kind of do my thing and then like go, hoping that I've left them better. So to hear somebody say so eloquently, I've been rocked. I mean, I'm so humbled and so appreciative of your words. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks. And thanks for coming. When we come back, a woman who lost her family in a fire wants answers from John, and John takes questions from our audience. We'll be right back.